Creed is great. 13 now, 13 was a 13 Ross back. You know, I jokes a lot on the videos, but I'm always serious no matter how I come, because I am a serious, I'm a serious Semitic my more. You know what I'm saying? I'm always serious. Even when I'm joking, I'm serious. I can get in a fight and be whooping by the ass, I'm gonna be laughing because I'm still gonna be serious. See my eyebrows drop like that? They drop up. Wait, let me stop. Hey, mango? I was gonna offer y'all some mango. I'm gonna put it inside my little ceramic thing I got. I'm gonna show y'all that too. I'm gonna show y'all some different things. Cause I'm gonna get a little personal with y'all. Not. Check this out. I've been drinking some coconut water. Y'all want some coconut? I'm a fool. Check this out. See, I had to show y'all how I really do eat. I eat and live. Cause I just wanna talk about it. I bees about it. Bees about it. Eat fruits and veggies all day long. That's it. And I'm with nature. So when people ask questions, they ask dumb questions. I don't answer your questions no more. So your questions are a waste of my time. So you can stop really asking me different things because I'm not going to respond. That's just real talk. You go looking at my old videos. I haven't even made a video saying I ain't answering your question. I'm not answering your questions no more. So you Johnny come lately are asking all these questions like, do this. What about this? What about that? Go look it up. Go do the research. Or am I your slave and you're my master? That's what you're acting like by asking me questions. You're not doing no due diligence on nothing. Because how can you get clarification? You don't take my word from it. Go look it up. But when you go look it up, you get clarification. And then you overstand what anything I'm saying. See, right now you're just understanding. I don't like stats. Real talk. Now check this. For you meat eaters. Oh, he's talking meat again. Up yours. People keep saying that they can eat this and that and all the kind of stuff on the planet. Well, I'm going to break it all the way down for you for the final and last draw. Because you're not in tune with nature because you're eating meat. Let me tell you something. We're living in this thing we call here the third dimension or third dimension, however you want to say it. This is also called beast state, as in beast state of mind, as in bestiality, as in this is run by the beast. Even though we are a beast because we're inside our skin, we're considered a beast because inside your good book, they told you we are the beast. That's 666, the number of the beast. That's the number of human. And 6 electrons, 6 protons, and 6 neutrons give you carbon or carbon base for some. But that is the beast. So the beast of the mind is the one that's driving the people crazy out here. Back in ancient times, such as like Kemet or India or wherever, they even had like the big cow there that is sacred. You know why the cow is sacred? Because the one with the horns got all the power. So when you look at just gods like a Zeus or a Thor and them like that, they got two horns on the head, represents power. You got one horn, it's still some power. But you got two horns, that's double the power. So when you see the ancient people on these walls and stuff, you're looking at power. The ones who in power. I bet you nobody never told you that, did they? But right now, we're being run by the ones with the horns, power. Bestiality, this beast state of mind out here running the beast. So when you eat the blood foods, as in such as animals, you're being controlled by the beast gods. That's why they try to say the devil had horns. Now keep eating your meats now. I told you I couldn't give it to your blood raw, that ether. Nothing but an ether now and I sniff it up. What you gonna say now? What you gonna say now, meat eater? That's why your life is in the situation it is in now. Because you continue to eat the meats. So when you continue to eat the meats, the beast gets inside your body. The blood flow gets inside your body. So you're going to act like an animal. Act like an animal. Bees like an animal. You are what you eat, animal. Now, if you act like a god, you live like a god. You eat from the fruit of the land, nature, the garden. They didn't say the Garden of Eve, did they? I'm just using this as what they say. As in Garden of Eve, I don't think they say the garden of the farm with animals. See, the beast controls this state right here we in, third dimension. It's some real talk. That's when they went to war, they blew that horn. That's the ones in charge, because the beast is in charge, the horn is in charge. This is real talk. I'm giving it to your blood raw. So, you have to stop this. Only how you can ascend is leave the animals alone. You have to get out of this animal state of mind. This is the truth. I'm not lying to you no more. Well, I ain't lying to you yet. But I'm trying to give you meat eaters until the last time. You cannot raise your kundalini energy up or raise your DNA up on an animal state, because on a higher dimension, they're not gonna let no fucking animal come up there, because the animal is in the lower part out here. They run this area down here. That's why this all animal land. And you're supposed to learn from them and work with them, and then you ascend above them as a higher species. But how can you be a higher species when you're eating them? So they're controlling you because you got their DNA inside of you. You start off as an animal state, as a reptilian state. And then you go to a higher level, as in the fourth circuit of the brain, or fourth dimension, to fifth dimension, as in higher being. That's why you look at the walls of Kemet, Egypt, so all the kind of animals and stuff like that. You're not supposed to be eating the animals, you're supposed to learn from them, and learn their knowledge and everything, how to do things. And you rise above them, then you rise up to like a godly level. Yes, sir. Nobody gives it to you like this. Now keep eating your meats. Netter rules, as in nature beings, sun children, not beastly children. Why you think I always talk about the beast? You are the beast, and you have to conquer yourself to reach your higher level, as in ascension. So you better clean. You got them colas out your steak, nasty ass meat eater. Destroying y'all, because y'all think I'm just a joke. I told y'all, hey, the gloves off now. I'm gonna start hitting you hard, but I'm gonna give it to you where it hurts. Now go ahead and get your rock on and get that rock that junk out your system. And another thing, why when you go, you eat all these foods and stuff, you know, your waistline gets bigger, you get more waste. See, you eating somebody else's waste and you're wasting food. That's why you're eating all this crap out here. Well, if you eat natural food, you won't have that much waste in you. Because you get all the nutrients out your body and everything. When you get all that meats and all this stuff, you gain all that waste inside your body. You ain't nothing but a waste. A human waste. Think about that. Toxic waste. That's sick. You need to think about this. But you think you got some good old T-bone steaks and stuff. I told you I never saw one grow on a tree. And then you want to pick out what animals you want to eat. Or you want to make a little pet animal as a dog. Your pet, but you want to go eat the other animal. Come on, man. Y'all don't even sound right. Y'all aces. Animal races. This is your boy, the 13th son. I'll be giving it to you blood and raw each and every time. So y'all better leave them animals alone and get out of this beast state of mind you in. Wait a second. Why is bestiality on the rise again now? Why are some of the countries like Switzerland and all this have legalized bestiality, having sex with animals? Because they've been run by the beasts. They're being controlled by the beast. Why is this? Kissing dogs in their mouth. Hunching dogs. Sucking dogs. You don't see this, cavemans and cavewomen? Using the beast state of mind. You have to rise above the beast state of mind to come to a human or a godly kind of person. This is real talk. You're talking to the Lion King. You hear me? I'll let your boy think.